this is Keallan here from Mesa Fitness. Come back to our TrainerTips Tuesday videos. We'll come with some more educational topics for you guys that either help you with your workout or help you with your overall fitness journey. The first thing we want to talk about is how to properly warm up. We see a lot of members come into the gym, they start their workout. We want to give you some advice about how to optimize your workout. Okay, so how to properly warm up is through a dynamic warm up. What that is in a perfect world is you come to the gym, 5 minutes of some sort of aerobic activity. So that's going to be jogging, rowing, elliptical, stairmaster, something of that sort to get the heart rate up and blood flow going. After that, you're going to want to move into some specific exercises that are going to mimic what you're about to do in your actual workout. So if I'm going to do maybe, you know, legs or something like that, I might do some walking lunges, some bodyweight squats, or you can actually do more muscle group specific or mobility specific movements that are going to maybe help open up the hips for squatting or something like that. And I want to touch more on that and give more specific examples in the following videos to come that are going to separate to upper body and lower body specific activation movements. Okay, and then obviously with that you can get long-term mobility and flexibility benefits. Maybe you have certain restrictions somewhere and you can kind of open that up before your workout. Okay. Alright, so jumping into things not to do before your workout, or obviously things that we don't recommend to do before your workout, is one, don't just come to the gym, hop into the squat rack, hop underneath the bench. Also we call this gripping and ripping. Like I said, do a dynamic warm-up, it's gonna optimize your workout, be more beneficial. Two, we don't recommend static stretching before your workout, just because there is some research out there that shows that it can decrease performance. It's not an end-all be-all, you're not gonna destroy your workout, but it would be more optimal to do a dynamic warm-up before your workout instead of that static stretching, okay? And then foam rolling, this is not necessarily something we don't recommend. I put it on there because we have a lot of questions on whether you need it before your workout or after your workout. Actually, you know, I don't prioritize this with clients before the workout unless something's like, you know, the quads or lats are really sore from the last session and we're about to train that again. I might have them spend time on that sore and tight muscles a little bit on that foam roller, then I'll have them hop into a workout. And then same thing, you know, you get a little bit tight after your workout, you can static stretch and or foam roll after your workout to promote better recovery. So tune in next week, I'll give you examples of some of my clients' upper body warm-ups and why we do them, why I implement that, and we'll see you then.